And now for today's Bible question. Today we have been learning about the teachings of Jesus and his power over every situation and over Satan and demons. And so someone might ask the question, can people today be possessed by demons? It seems that today many are teaching that we all have demons in us that we need to be delivered from. Many hold services designed to help deliver people from demonic influences. This, for the most part, seems to be quite contrived and staged. Demons are real, and they do have some influence upon our lives, if we allow them. The scripture speaks of not letting Satan get a foothold and resisting the devil, and he will flee from you. Some Christians may get involved in sins, which puts them especially in the way of Satan's attack. But we must be careful not to think of demon possession as we see here in Matthew 8 and in other gospel accounts. We notice in these accounts that those who were demon-possessed were led into violent seizures and superhuman powers and were outcast of society. The man in Matthew chapter 8 was not ever in a normal state of mind, but wandered in the tombs and cut himself running about with no clothes. This was a very antisocial and violent and self-destructive behavior. I fear that many who would claim demonic possession today are people who generally live normal lives and socialize fine with others, but may have been convinced that some sinful tendency must mean they are possessed of some evil spirit. This is leading many to falsely assume that demons are everywhere and afflicting people, and we give far more credit to Satan than he deserves. There may be rare cases of demonic possession, but I can assure you, you will likely recognize it rather quickly because of the very violent and antisocial behavior. I once met a man who violently was shouting, even foaming at the mouth, in opposition to some gospel preaching. When I saw the very violent behavior and physical hostility to Christ and his gospel, it appeared to me the work of Satan, and perhaps I could go so far as to say the man was possessed of a demon. But I would want to be very careful before making such a claim. We know that men can behave very sinfully and then blame their actions on the devil. The fact is that we are all wicked and sinful creatures, and much of our sinful behavior is simply because we have chosen to disobey God and to fulfill our sinful desires. We ought not to blame the devil for the poor choices we make, or for the weaknesses and sinfulness of our own flesh. Yes, Satan may be an influence, but only if we give way to him. Be careful not to identify demon possession with any and every bad thing that comes into our lives or that comes from within us. We do not want to make church services just a circus scene of dramatic displays of demon deliverance that is nothing more than human emotion and contrived antics. When Satan is controlling a person through a demon, we shall not even want to be anywhere around that person, for they will be violent, antisocial, and not in a right state of mind. I have witnessed those who apparently are fine one minute, but the next minute they are vibrating around the room and screeching as though a demon needs to be cast out of them. A moment later they are fine again. This is just a sham, a show to fool the audience. A person possessed would not be sitting in a church service calmly before erupting into convulsions. This is simply showmanship and is a travesty to the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Yes, demon possession is possible, but quite rare today. It was more evident in Jesus' day because Jesus' presence brought forth and exposed quickly the work of Satan, who wanted to destroy the plan of God through Jesus Christ. Satan is much more effective at leading people astray through their own lust than through demonic oppression. People can become much more susceptible to the influence of Satan when they are involved in witchcraft and other evil practices which God hates. Nevertheless, do not rejoice in this, that the spirits are subject to you, but rather rejoice because your names are written in heaven. Luke chapter 10, verse 20.